Hello everyone, this is third lecture on engineering geology. In the last lecture we have discussed allied branches of geology, scope of geological studies in different civil engineering projects and departments in India which deals with geological studies. Okay, now we come to mineralogy. Under this we will study what is mineral, origin and composition of mineral, physical properties and how to identify minerals. So the question is why we go for mineralogy? What is the need of mineralogy? See, the study of rocks is one of the main motive of this subject engineering geology, and I have already told you minerals are the basic or fundamental unit of rock, means rocks are formed by minerals. So it is essential to have idea about mineralogy before moving forward. Okay, so the question is, what is mineral? Mineral may be defined as natural, inorganic, homogeneous, solid substance having a definite chemical composition and regular atomic structure. It means all materials around us cannot be described as minerals. So to call any substance a mineral, the requirements are: it must be formed by a natural process, it must be inorganic substance. What is organic or inorganic compound? Organic compounds contain carbon hydrogen bond, okay, and the compounds other than organic compound are called inorganic substances. What is homogeneous? When the property of material is same at all the points, then that kind of material is called homogeneous. So it must be homogeneous, it must be solid, having a definite chemical composition. Okay, it should have its own chemical composition. For example, in quartz mineral, it is having chemical formula as SiO2. Clear? And regular atomic structure means there should be a regular pattern of atoms in the internal structure of the substance. Clear? For example, in the quartz mineral, the basic structural unit is SiO4, silica tetrahedron. Okay, here silicon is connected to 4 oxygen atom. Okay, so since this pattern is tetrahedron, that's why it is known as silica tetrahedron. So this is the basic structural unit of quartz. These tetrahedron units are connected such that each oxygen atom is shared by 2 tetrahedron unit. Okay, so it gives the overall chemical formula of this quartz mineral as SiO2. Clear? So here we can see there is a definite pattern of atoms in quartz mineral. There are some minerals which do not satisfy the requirements to be called as a mineral. Such type of minerals falls under exceptions in mineral. For example, coal, amber, petroleum and natural gas, these are typical organic substances, but from the definition to be called as a mineral, it must be inorganic substance. Bauxite, kaolinite, fluorite and coal are not homogeneous, but from definition it must be homogeneous. Asphalt, coprolite, petroleum, mercury and natural gas are semi-solids, liquids or gases. Okay, but the substance called mineral when it is a solid substance. Clear? But here some of them are semi-solids, liquids or gases. Flint, chert, jasper and augite are cryptocrystalline, means these minerals do not have a well developed crystal structure. So these are some exceptions in mineral that we must know. Now we look at the formation of minerals. Basically, there are three natural processes by which minerals are formed: solidification of magma from secondary process and under metamorphism. Most of the minerals like feldspar, quartz, pyroxene, these minerals are formed directly or indirectly out of magma during different stages of its solidification. Okay, what is magma? Magma is a molten or semi-molten material which is found beneath the outer surface. Okay, so when magma solidifies, it becomes a solid substance, which is the process of formation of magma. So these are some examples of minerals which are formed by solidification of magma. Some minerals like calcite, dolomite, bauxite, and coal. These are the minerals which are formed by secondary process like weathering, precipitation, and deposition. Okay, so these minerals are formed by weathering, precipitation, and deposition. Another important mode of formation of minerals is out of metamorphism. Okay, these minerals are formed under the influence of high temperatures and pressures with or without the active involvement of chemically active solutions. Some example of the minerals which are formed by the process of metamorphism are kyanite, garnet, chlorite, graphite, talc, etc. Okay, so these are the minerals which are formed by the process of metamorphism. What is metamorphism? Metamorphism is the process by which the pre-existing minerals subjected to high temperature or pressure beneath the surface of earth, and they undergo some structural arrangements. Okay, so this process is metamorphism. Now we come to classification of minerals. Minerals are broadly classified into two groups. First one is rock forming mineral, second one is economic minerals. Rock forming minerals. These are the minerals which form different types of rocks. Okay, and the minerals other than rock forming minerals are grouped under economic minerals. Economic minerals are further classified into two groups. First one is metallic minerals, second one is non-metallic. Some economic minerals like hematite, galena, chromite. These minerals are used for the extraction of valuable metals. Okay, so these minerals are grouped under metallic economic minerals. And some other economic minerals like asbestos, graphite, and magnesite. These economic minerals are useful by virtue of their physical properties. Okay, means from these minerals we cannot extract metals, and they are useful because of their some physical properties. So these minerals are grouped under non-metallic economic minerals. From civil engineering point of view, economic minerals are not relevant. So mainly we have to focus on rock forming minerals. Some example of rock forming minerals are feldspars, quartz, mafic minerals, etc. According to an estimate, 99.9% of the Earth's crust, means upper layer of Earth, is composed of 20 to 25 rock forming minerals. Means rock forming minerals are very abundant in the Earth crust. And the reason for such occurrence is that the elements that enter into the formation of minerals are derived from the rocks of the outer crust of the Earth or from magma. Means the outer crust rock elements and elements derived from the magma participate in the formation of minerals. And we know the solidification of magma form the rocks. Okay, that's why the rock forming minerals are abundant in Earth crust. The interesting thing that we should know here is 98% of rock forming minerals are silicates only. Okay, so our Earth crust is rich of silicate minerals. Now we come to methods of study of minerals. So if we want to study the minerals in a systematic way, so we should go for its physical property, chemical composition, optical properties, and X-ray analysis. Okay, so this study will give you the complete knowledge or information about the mineral. So firstly, we look at the physical properties of minerals, like form, color, luster, hardness, cleavage, fracture, etc. Okay, so firstly we discuss form of the mineral. This is one of the first observations made when a mineral is examined in a hand specimen. Okay, so when a mineral specimen we keep in our hand, so first of all we observe its form. Form means the appearance of the mineral, means how your mineral is look like. The form represent the common mode of occurrence of a mineral in nature. Okay, so by observing the form, we can comment on the mode of formation or occurrence of a mineral. Means we can say that this mineral is formed by solidification of magma, or by weathering, means by secondary process, or by the metamorphism. Clear? To some extent, form is a function of atomic structure. Okay, so by observing the form, we can assess its atomic structure. Since some minerals consistently exhibit the same form, so it provides a valuable clue for mineral identification. Clear? By observing the form, we can identify the mineral. But due caution should be exercised in arriving at a conclusion based on this property, because the same mineral may exhibit different forms, or different minerals may exhibit the same form. Clear? So sometimes what happens, two different minerals shows the same form, and two same minerals shows the different form. So we cannot conclude that the mineral is this one. We need to go for other physical properties to identify the mineral. Clear? These are some typical forms of minerals. Firstly, we look at lamellar form. The mineral which shows lamellar form appears as thin separable layers. Look at this figure. Here you can easily identify these thin separable layers. Okay, each layer you can separate. So this is the example of mica mineral. Next is tabular form. In this type of form, the mineral appears as slab of uniform thickness. Okay, so this is the example of gemstone bus, which is one of the mineral of feldspar group. Here in this image, you can easily identify the slabs of uniform thickness. Clear? This is one slab, this is another slab. Next one is fibrous form. Here the mineral appears to be made up of fine threads. For example, in asbestos, you can see the fine threads. Okay. In piezolytic form, the mineral appears to be made up of small spherical grains. See, in bauxite mineral, here you can identify these small balls. Small spherical grains. Okay. So, by observing the form, we can somehow identify which kind of mineral it is. Okay. Next physical property is color. Color in minerals imparted due to its chemical composition, atomic structure, presence of trace elements, strain effect, etc. Usually, minerals exhibit uniform color throughout the body, but there are some minerals which show some peculiarities. For example, bauxite. Okay. In bauxite, you cannot define bauxite by a particular color. You can see here many colors are there. Okay, so bauxite represent peculiarity in color. Greater consistency in color is noticed in case of metallic minerals. Okay, metallic minerals generally have their specific color. Idiochromatic. These are the minerals which have characteristic and constant color. For example, galena, hematite, graphite, coal, sulfur. Okay, these are the minerals which comes under category of idiochromatic. Why? Because these minerals we can define by a particular color. Allochromatic. The minerals which have variable color. For example, quartz. You can find quartz in many colors. Okay. Here we have seen the color is imparted due to the chemical composition of the mineral. But in some minerals, color is not related to its chemical composition. For example, in diamond and graphite, okay, both are having same chemical composition, but their physical appearance is very different. Here you can see the color of diamond is colorless and it is transparent. Okay. But color of graphite is black and opaque. Clear? So always color cannot be related to its chemical composition. So enough care should be taken while identifying any mineral through the color. Here we can see diagnostic colors of some minerals. The color of galena is dark lead gray. Color of sulfur is yellow. Color of olivin is olive green. The ruby is of red color. And here we can see the minerals which show different colors. For example, quartz is available in white color, pink color, green color, and also it is colorless. In case of feldspar, we can see here white color is there, gray color is there, and this is dirty white. Okay. Similarly, in calcite, colorless, white, gray, yellow, some shades of red color also there. Clear? So in the next lecture, we will continue with other physical properties of minerals. Thank you.